G'day everyone, I'm Dr. Peter Price of Classroom Professor. This week in the Free Math Worksheet series, we're looking at multiplying by fractions. So on the very first of the worksheets, it starts off with a set of questions starting with this one, 1/9 times 45. So they're multiplying unit fractions by whole numbers, and of course they will relate to times tables, number facts the students have already done. On the right-hand side at the top, we have a similar set, only they're reversed. So they're the turnaround questions, if you like. 28 multiplied by 1/7 and so on. So unit fractions, meaning all we have to do is work out that it's division, do the division, there's our answer. The next sets of questions on both sides of the sheet have pairs of questions that are related to each other. So the first one in the second set is 1/6 times 30. And then the following question is 4/6 times 30. So they're in pairs like that. So the first one is a unit fraction. The next one is the same denominator but a different numerator. So let's look at this question, 1/9 times 45. What we're not going to do is to say, well, look, this just means divide, put the 9 under the 45, you know, and use some symbolic method. At the point where the students are learning how to do this and learning what it means, we want to help them to understand it. So here's my suggestion. Give the students large pieces of paper and felt pens or crayons or something like that that they can draw with. Ask them to draw a shape. And for ninths, it's probably easiest if you say draw a square, because that's going to make it easy to make it into 9 pieces. And say, all right, divide that into 9 equal pieces. And it doesn't matter how the students do it, but they might work out that if you did 3 rows of 3, that's a nice simple way of doing it. Now we want to put 45 objects or pictures in that shape so that they are evenly distributed among the parts. Now I can draw dots, but instead I'm going to write symbols here. The students should quickly understand, providing they know their 9 times table, that they're going to be 5 objects in each set. And that quickly gives us our answer. So if we have 1/9 of 45, it's the same as dividing by 9. And there's our answer. So we can relate this back to the number facts, the times tables the students have done, 5/9 of 45. We can turn all of that around and look at the related number fact. 45 divided by 9 is 5. 1/9 of 45 is 9. Great. So they're one-step questions. The symbols are different, and we use fraction language and fraction pictures. But once we can make that connection between fractions and division, these are not hard. Now let's look at the follow-up question. Supposing the next question was 6/9 times 45. So we have the same whole number, 45, the same denominator, but a different numerator. This is now a two-step question. But providing you know the answer to the first one, this isn't going to be that hard. Now, using the diagram that the students drew earlier, we could ask them to shade or circle 6/9 of the shape. Quite an easy question, assuming they know that, you know, that they're familiar with fractions. And then we could say, well, what will that answer be if we see there are 5s in each of the 9ths, 6 of those equals 30. There's our answer. So we can relate this to this one and say that 5 multiplied by 6, that's an equal sign, by the way, equals 30. So as I said, there are two steps to it, but what we don't, again, to emphasize the point, I suppose, what we don't want them to do is to learn some algorithmic do this, then do that, then do the other method at this point. When they're just getting used to it, we want to say, well, do you know what 1/9 is? Work out 1/9, multiply that by 6 because we've got 6 of them and so on. Okay, that's it from me. I look forward to talking to you next week, and I hope that you enjoy using the worksheets.